The Sound of Life presents another Adopt-A-Nation Prayer Project Spotlight.
The minority Christian population in Mali is praising God for liberation from Islamic terrorists by French troops. Situated above Côte d'Ivoire and Burkina Faso, northern Malians understand the peril of power vacuums caused by internal tribal fighting. Al-Qaeda is on the rise in North Africa, and filling the power vacuum in Mali and its capital, Bamako, is central to Al-Qaeda's rise. Members of Gospel Missionary Inland Church started praying nonstop when the terrorists first arrived in Mopti. Islamists had targeted Christians and churches in other northern cities. We started praying and God answered our prayers. All the members of this church were spared and nothing happened to them. God cares for His children, and no matter what happens, we will trust in Him, declared the church pastor. During the occupation of Diabali, Pascal Torres' small house on the outskirts of town hid 27 Christian refugees, terrified of being singled out for persecution by the occupying Islamists. Some locals reported where the Christians were. The refugees have now returned to their own homes, but life in the town will not be the same for Christians. Father in heaven, thank you for protecting the Mopti Church. Prompt relief organizations to aid Malian Christians as they rebuild their lives after the Islamic occupation. Enable the pastors to minister comfort and healing to their terrified flocks. We pray in Jesus' name, amen. To learn more about Malian believers, visit persecution.org.
Praying for persecuted believers, the Adopt-A-Nation Prayer Project, and the Sound of Life.